Under welding process, next topic is arc welding. The heat required for melting and joining the plates are obtained by electrical arcs, then it is called as arc welding. Okay. Under arc welding, we have three types. One is DCSP, direct current same polarity. Second one is direct current reverse polarity, and third one is alternative current high frequency. Okay, principle is same. Okay, first I'll explain what is DCSP. Okay, under this, the negative terminal of power supply is connected to electrode, that is cathode. Okay, and the positive terminal of power supply is connected to anode. Okay, when the power is supplied and the arc, that is the gap, is maintained between cathode and anode, okay, a very high velocity of negatively charged electrons is generated at cathode. Okay, this high velocity negatively charged electrons are attracted towards anode. Okay, they are attracted towards anode, and simultaneously from anode positively charged ions are produced. Okay, in between time, kinetic energy of negatively charged electrons is converted to heat energy. When the negatively charged electrons are attracted towards anode, it produces a very large velocity. The kinetic energy of electrons are converted to heat energy. Okay, so the heat energy produced at anode is very high compared to heat energy produced at cathode, because when the anode produces positively charged ions, okay, it gets attracted towards the cathode, but the velocity of negatively charged electrons are very high compared to the velocity of positively charged ions. Okay, so at workpiece, the heat generated is 67%, and at electrode, heat generated is 33%. Because at cathode, it produces negatively charged electrons. Okay, it is coming towards anode, so anode receives more amount of heat. At anode, more amount of heat is generated compared to cathode. Okay, so under this, you have to remember two things. First point is cathode, it produces negatively charged electrons. Cathode produces negatively charged electrons. These electrons are attracted towards the anode. Okay, and from anode positively charged ions are produced. These ions are attracted towards cathode. Simultaneously, kinetic energy of electrons is converted to heat energy. And the velocity of electrons is more compared to velocity of ions. Because of this, at anode, heat generation is more. Okay, the maximum temperature attained is 5000 to 6000 degrees Celsius. Okay, second is direct current reverse polarity. Same principle, but here the positive terminal of power supply is connected to electrode and the negative terminal is connected to cathode. So wherever there is anode, the heat generated is more. Wherever there is anode, heat generated is more compared to cathode. Cathode heat generated is less compared to this. Okay, I forgot to say one important point. See, in DCSP, at workpiece, 67% of heat is generated. So it is used for DCSP is used for welding very high melting point metals. It is used for welding very high melting point metals, and the depth of the welding is also huge, because at workpiece huge amount of heat is generated compared to other two welding process. Okay, and in DCRP compared to DCSP, at workpiece a low amount of heat is generated. Because of this, it is only used for a very low melting point metals, and the thickness of the plates which can be welded is also very low. Okay, and because of this, the deposition rate is high. See the deposition rate compared to other two welding process. In DCRP, the deposition rate is very high. Okay, so because of this, higher welding speed is possible compared to other two welding process. In DCRP, high welding speed is possible because of high deposition rate. Okay, and coming to ACHF, alternating current high frequency, the heat generated at anode and cathode is given in ratio 1:1, and the frequency is 50 Hz. So time taken is equal to one wave frequency, that is 0.02 seconds. Here the positive and negative terminal keeps on changing the polarity, so there is uniform heat generated in cathode and anode, okay, or electrode and workpiece. So the conditions at ACHF is in between DCSP and DCRP. Okay, so for gate exam you have to remember all these things. Okay, so this is formula number 3. Thank you.